AIM-listed WRES Resources is carrying out a strategic review of operations to fast-track those at their La Parrilla and Regua mines and change how the La Parrilla tailing project runs. The tungsten, copper and gold exploration, development and production company has assets in Spain and Portugal. Michael Masterson is the company's chairman, and he's left his hard hat on site and joins me now. Thanks for coming
Fantastic
into the studio.
To be here.
Now, tell me a little bit more about this strategic review. I mean, what does it really change?
Look, it's probably the simplest way to explain it. It's all about the mines. We have a very large mine at La Parrilla. We have a emerging large mine at Regua. The message from the strategic review is focus on the mines, put the management effort into the mines, make sure that those are highly economic mine developments and ready to go progressively through this year and next year.
So are they going to get moving quicker than you might have said before? Because in September you said that this was the focus, and then in November you said, look, progress is great, we've started drilling, we're getting busy.
Well, I think probably one of the big things that's changed is we built a tailings facility, we had successful production of tungsten, we had sales to customers. Our operational review is saying there are technical ways in which we can use all of that infrastructure, the power, the plant and everything else, to get to early mining at La Parrilla and to feed some of the ore from La Parrilla, from Regua, through the plant at La Parrilla.
So at La Parrilla tailing, mm-hmm. I mean, that's been a nice little earner for you, isn't it? Hasn't it? But now you're changing the way that's going to run. So, you know what's been happening to the price of tungsten. How far, how big a role has that played in reshaping the strategy?
Well, I think the tungsten price has come down. That says to us, focus using the tailings plant to develop the mine quickly, because we'll make a lot more money.
So you're shifting it slightly. You've still got the tailing on the side, but this is the number one priority.
Rather than the stage by stage. So while tungsten prices are lower, and we do expect to bounce back post Chinese New Year, if we can prove up the mines, test the flow sheets, make the mines much more robust and much more profitable, that's the best thing to do with the tailings plant, rather than just running the tailings alone on a continuous basis to make tungsten.
The weather wasn't so good in the last part of 2014. What impact has that had on progress?
Well, December was a very messy month. We had very heavy rains, which stopped access to the high-grade tungsten areas, and then we had some problems with our flocculant that gave us a few headaches. In itself, that was a one-off. We've addressed those issues. But, you know, with the tungsten price around $270, $300, it's better to focus on the mines, because the mines have higher grades and we can use the tailings facilities to get the mines up and running more quickly.
Okay, let's talk about funding, because that can sometimes be tricky for smaller companies. I know that you had a share issue in January, but what else are you doing to make sure that you've got the funds to get these programs up and running?
Well, we raised £1.4 million in January, and that brought in a strategic investor in the form of Hansource, so great to have them on the register. They've got a background that's very experienced in resources, and I think they'll be a great shareholder to have on board. We've also announced today a funding facility from BBVA, the second largest bank in Spain. That will significantly improve our working capital management. When you're selling tungsten, receiving VAT, managing all the cash flows, if you've got a bank facility, it makes it a hell of a lot easier to manage things.
And I just want to go back to Hansource there. I mean, yeah, you said yourself, they're a strategic investor. I think they've got 11.5% voting rights.
Yeah.
How does that change the strategy for you? Because there's someone else at the table.
It's good to have a cornerstone strategic investor who can do a whole variety of things to support the company in terms of how it develops financially. We've also got very strong interest from our customers to look at a range of financing options. So we're very, very confident that when all the approvals are in place to develop La Parrilla and Regua, we will have the funding and the backing of very, very good investors to develop those two projects.
Now, you're hoping the market's going to like it, so let's talk about the share price, because recently some brokers, they've lowered your price target to from 1.5 to 1.1 pence, but you're trading near your 52-week lows, so...
Yeah, share price is crazy.
Okay, I know there's been some dilution, but you know, what's going to be the catalyst for change there?
Look, the big drivers of value for the shareholders is the La Perla mine and the Regua mine. $100 million, this is the net present value of La Perla. $40 million is the net present value of Regua. We do all the key things necessary to put those two mines in production and get them funded, and it'll be like night and day in terms of where our share price is.
Thanks ever so much, Michael. So getting La Perla and Regua up and running is top of your to-do list for 2015.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And you know when you watch sometimes on the interviews on TV,